ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಹಂಪಿ ಹುಳಿ, ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಇನ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕೆ ಎಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಗೋಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಬೆಳಗಾವಿ, ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಅಂಬ್ರೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಆಫ್ ವಿಶ್ವೇಶ್ವರಯ್ಯ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೆಸನ್ ಆಫ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್. 18 MAT 31 ಥರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲಸ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೆಸನ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಸನ್ ವಿ learned what is a double integration, triple integration definitions, and how to evaluate certain examples. So today I am continuing with examples. So this is lecture number 2 of 18 MAT 11 third module, that is integral calculus or double and triple integrations. So I am continuing with the next type of examples. Suppose we are asked to find next example is evaluate double integration of 0 to 1, again both are constant limits, dx dy square root of 1 minus x square square root of 1 minus y square. Now since both the limits are same, I can assign here, there is no problem, but anyway I am assigning x limits here, and since in this example no problem, both are constant limits, same limits, so first let me integrate with respect to x. So I write integrate with respect to x. So always when there are two variables, independent variables, we keep remaining independent variables, here only one y is there, keep y as constant, or we write keeping y as constant, keeping or treating. So this part we don't touch. This part we don't touch, this part we don't touch, this part we don't touch. Hence I proceed, y equal to 0 to 1 I don't touching. So dy part I am not touching. Square root of 1 minus y square I am not touching. That means only integration of 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square dx, that becomes sine inverse x. Between x equal to 0 to 1. So first let us complete the limits. Y equal to 0 to 1 as it is, dy as it is, square root of 1 minus y square as it is, upper limit sine inverse of 1 minus lower limit sine inverse of 0. We know that y equal to 0 to 1, sine inverse of 1 is pi by 2, because sine pi by 2 is 1, sine of 90 degrees is 1. So if you take sine this side, sine inverse of 1 becomes pi by 2. Similarly, sine 0 is 0. If I take sine this side, sine inverse of 0 is 0. Just I reminded you. So pi by 2 minus 0 and 1 upon square root of 1 minus y square dy as it is. Now, if I integrate with respect to y, just like x it is, I becomes pi by 2, I can write outside. Y becomes sine inverse of y, integration is sine inverse of y, 0 to 1. So now, again it becomes just like the sine inverse case. That also becomes 1. So let me use the same technique and write it as, this also becomes pi by 2 minus 0, because you have seen here very similar one. So this becomes, answer is pi square by 4. Once again, dx dy, square root of 1 minus x square, square root of 1 minus y square. First, with respect to x, this becomes sine inverse of x between x equal to 0 to 1, upper limit minus lower limit, pi by 2 minus 0. Similarly, this also becomes pi by 2 minus 0. Here, one more alternative is there. If both are constant limits, this I can be split in terms of, and if both are factors, like y equal to 0 to 1, separately you can write. And x equal to 0 to 1 separately you can write, that is double integration can be split into product of two single integrations. And the same answer definitely we get, which is pi by 2 into pi by 2, pi square by 4. Or reverse, two double integrations, two single integrations, if both are constant limits, can be combined into one double integration of this pattern. So this is the relation, provided limits should be constants. Two conditions, limits should be constants and x part and y part should be as factors. So here we go for the next example. See, more number of example we do, we get used to it. Last class I told that word is very important, please. Getting used to, getting familiar to is very important. So next example, let us get used to the next example. I take a little higher level, I take triple integration, 1 to 3, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4. What we have to integrate, let us see, x, y square, z cube. So we are getting used to this concept of double or triple integration. So this is I equal to, first of all you have to assign which is x, which is y, which is z. So in this case, by customary, let us assign first one is x, 1, 2, 3 it is, second one is y, third one is z. Suppose if I write, this is, suppose if I write dz dx dy, then I'd have written here z x y. If at all this would have been there, I'd have written z x y. So now this is not there, this is not there. Let us integrate. Now if at all I integrate with respect to x, here also you can split into three single integrations and integrate. So this example, if I write z as it is, y as it is, so y as it is, so and x I'll integrate. So I write integrate with respect to x, keeping other two variables y and z as constants, so that y square, z cube, dy, dz, no change. X part, dx part, x raised to 1 becomes x raised to 2 by 2. And what are the limits for x? 1, 2, 3. Upper limit minus lower limit, z equal to 3 to 4 as it is, y equal to 1 to 2 as it is. Don't get tempted to do two operations, putting limit also and integrating y also. It is not necessary. It will take little more time. Upper limit, first I put here 3, 3 square, minus put I put 1, this 1 here, divide by 2, y square, z cube, dy, dz. So 9 minus 1, 8 by 2 I can write outside, which is 4, and I can integrate with respect to y, keeping z constant, taking z as constant. So z as it is, z cube dz as it is, only y square dy part, y cube by 3 between 1 to 2. So this part is 4, z as it is, 2 cube minus 1 cube, z cube dz. So then I integrate with respect to z at last. Integrate with respect to z as the last variable. 4 as it is, this part simplification I will take outside. 8 minus 1 by 3, which is 7 by 3, I can take outside. Z cube dz becomes z raised to 4 by 4. Whatever the limits are there, 3 to 4. So now, as long as constant limits are there, you are keeping one constant, one variable moving and remaining as constants. 4, 7 by 3 into, now this becomes 4 raised to 4 minus 3 raised to 4. Okay, divided by 4. Let us see what all we are going to get, which is 4 into 7 by 3, okay, 4 raised to 4, 16 square minus 9 square, okay. So that becomes 175. You can very easily check, numerator becomes 175 upon 4. So there is a very easy simplification. You can cancel 4 here and you can make use of 3 divisible here. So that the final answer I'd like to give you 385. Very easily you can check. Let us see what all we did in this example. So triple integration asked. See children. Triple integration asked. So with respect to x, y, z, because of this order, first one is x, second one is y, third one is z, I kept y and z constants. X raised to 1 becomes x raised to 2 by 3, x raised to 2 by 2, upper limit minus lower limit. Then proceed to find the value as 8 by 2, which becomes 4, and then y square becomes y cube by 3. Again, 2 raised to 3 minus 1 raised to 3, carefully substitute the limits. Here, whatever upper limit is there, 2 minus 1, 2 raised to 3 minus 1 raised to 3. And 8 minus 1, 7 by 3. Z raised to 4 by 4. Again, put limits 4 and 3. 4 raised to 4 minus 3 raised to 4. You can get 385. So let us get used to next variety. So there are variety of integrations. So where we'll have to integrate. Now I'll take one more example. Again, triple integration. Evaluate is there. Again, I'll take the constant limits only. 0 to 3, 0 to 0 to 1. So in the previous case, they were factors like x into y square into z cube. There also you would have split it as the previous case. Alternatively, you would have split it as with respect to x, 0 to 1, separately dx, separately dy, separately dz, split into 3 product of 3 ordinary integrations. I'll come back to that. But here, what is the integrand given? Whatever is inside the integration function, that is known as, this is known as integrand. So the order of the integration is z, x, y. That means first one is for z, second one is for x, third one is for y. So let us assign it I equal to 0 to 3, 0 to 2, 0 to 1. First one is for z.